The top issue, frankly, is that we've run out of internet address space. This is an obscure issue, but we need to move to what is called IP version 6 with a very, very large number of addresses. Otherwise, it would be like a telephone system that ran out of telephone numbers, and we don't want that. We want the net to keep growing. The second big issue is keeping the network as open as possible to invite as much innovation as we can with as little barrier to that innovation as possible, so that new Googles and Amazons and PayPals and Skypes can happen all around the world. The third thing we need to worry about is how to make the network safer to use. There are many different kinds of attacks, malware, other kinds of viruses and worms, things that invade people's computers and take them over and use them as what we call botnets. There are many kinds of abuses that take place on the net. We have to find ways of minimizing that. We'll never get rid of it, but we can take technical means and we can adopt legal practices on an international basis in order to minimize some of these problems and improve the safety of the network. All of that will contribute to improved e-commerce, it will contribute to opportunities to create new innovations, and it will create the opportunity to use the network in ways that probably none of us can even imagine. So now let's talk a little bit about things I wish that we could make happen. One of the things that cloud computing has contributed to the internet's environment is a framework in which collaboration can happen. Multiple parties can see and interact with the same information. We see a similar kind of leveraging capability that shows up when we have common databases, for example, scientific information. The Human Genome Project, with all of its databases, means that if you're studying genetics, and specifically sequences, genetic sequences, and you say, what do we know about this sequence that I've just discovered? You can go query this common database that everyone has contributed to. And this allows you to find out not only what do we know, but who knows it. This allows you to get connected. So this idea of collaboration and sharing of information and being able to work together on it in this online environment is extremely powerful. We've just begun, I think, to explore that possibility. Finally, let me mention one other rather ambitious project. It started in 1998. And began with the question, what should we be doing now that we will need in 25 years? And one of the answers to that question was, why don't we build an internet that can function across the solar system? Sounds like science fiction, but it's actually very practical. If we're going to send many robotic missions and even manned missions to the outer planets, we need to have communication. And historically, all the communication that we've used in the past has been point-to-point radio links between Earth and the destination robot or the destination astronaut. The idea of creating a rich networking environment allows for much, much more complicated missions to occur, where we have orbiters around the planet, we have mobile and fixed instruments on the surface, we have multiple spacecraft that are flying in tandem in order to do interferometric studies. There are all kinds of possibilities. So this project to create an interplanetary internet has actually borne fruit. We have new protocols because the standard internet protocols didn't work in interplanetary distances. They are now being standardized by the Consultative Committee on Space Data Systems. We have them on board the International Space Station. We have them on board the Epoxy spacecraft, which just rendezvoused with a comet, Hartley 2, in November of 2010. So we can now see the possibility of literally growing an interplanetary backbone one mission at a time. Each mission, having completed its primary responsibilities, could then be turned into and repurposed as a communication node of an interplanetary internet. And so, as the decades unfold, we may actually see the internet go off-planet.